So everybody, welcome to Cafe Rainy Days. The whole concept of Cafe Rainy Days is to introduce us and converse with people who provide us with inspiration, to really give us that motivational push, you know. And one such person that we're going to meet today is Prajakta Wadhavkar. So I'm going to introduce you to Prajakta and I'm going to read through my notes. So Prajakta Wadhavkar is a managing director and founder of Tapas Elder Care in Pune. Tapas has two setups, one specializing in dementia care and the other which is non-dementia and what Prajakta calls active aging. Tapas has been recognized by several medical bodies for its excellent services and organizations such as the Indian Geriatric Society, such as the Non-Resident Indian Parents Organization. Prajakta has won several awards, including recently the Indian Achievers Award. She has been a guest speaker at several prestigious organizations such as IIT, Flame Institute, and really it's providing the best of quality care to the elderly. So over to Prajakta. Prajakta, tell us a bit about Tapas. Tell us why Tapas is not the usual, in Marathi, what you call Vruddhashram, the regular elderly care facility.
Hi, Sujata. It's a privilege to be with you. And let's begin with what you've asked. As you said, the general Vruddhashram carries a lot of baggage. The term Vruddhashram carries a lot of baggage. Again, in India, with our cultural and traditional background, of course, it has a sort of a stigma to it. So I had to, you know, work on things where we need to get rid of the stigma, where we need to make it a happy place, plus where it can systematically offer services that are vital for this age group. And as I slowly began to actually do this survey, I realized the need for neurological and psychological disorders as well. Mm-hmm. So the specialized and systematic setup took place. And right from registering it to getting things in place, just getting the expert care, because I'm not a doctor, I'm a founder, I have all this in mind and I can manage it well. But then, you know, I need to have the respective experts in place. Mm-hmm. So then it all shaped up. Somehow I was blessed to meet good people, good doctors who were dedicated, who could actually feel the cause.
Remember, Prajakta, when we were speaking earlier, you said when you set out to register the organization, there weren't even procedures in place as to how do you register a facility like that. Perhaps there were many facilities that weren't even registered.
Absolutely, yeah. This actually happened when I actually felt now I'm ready to actually get this registered. I'm ready to actually look at a place where I can do this, where I can actually start a residential care home for senior citizens. I was running from pillar to post, you know, going through government organizations and government offices, and it was not very encouraging. And so we went to the social welfare department, we went to the regular post of government offices just to find out how do we do this.
And because you wanted to do it right.
Well, I wanted to do it right and in a very legally safeguarded way. So we then went to the Ministry of Health and we got the right people to guide us through the procedures. And we have this registered under the Mental Health Act with the Ministry of Health. So there's a proper procedure for a license, for inspections. So it is actually, which people don't know, but there are systems in place. We need to adhere to it and follow it.
Tell us a bit about the activities that happen at Tapas. For example, the Geriatric Society and some other surveys as well have really praised you for the sort of work that you're doing with dementia. What sort of activities you're going through with these senior citizens?
A cognitive decline is very common or very lightly taken, but once a dementia, when it is diagnosed, it's a very sad and an unfortunate situation for the person as well as the family. We haven't found a cure as yet. So this was one point where I was actually motivated to do it. So the day they come to us, we have a great detailed personal history written down as to what they like, what they don't like, what makes them upset, or what were their routine, what was the line of work. So accordingly, we started planning the activities. The whole objective is to keep them busy. And it should be kind of a meaningful socialization. So I have a complete floor for activities. Morning time is more for creative activities. There's music going on. There are more interesting activities going on, which relate to the times when they were actually active or working. And they had actually lost the ability to write or hold a pen. And we've seen that within weeks or months, they've started painting. So we've seen miracles happen here. I encourage a lot of research and scientists here. But of course, like activities, what we've seen, and our structured routine, a structured diet, which helps as much as medication at this point.
And talk a bit about Prajakta, how you encourage new skills and how you actually got a counselor who will sit with the
This concept took place was when the dementia patients, or we can say senior citizens with dementia or cognitive impairment, started coming in and we could actually confidently take care of them. So they were family members or their children or friends who were actually have this, you know, ki, would I go through the same thing? Or even people in their 40s used to come and say, like we forget even names even now at the age of 40 and 50. So it got me thinking, what makes the brain, what stimulates the brain is learning something new. So we came up with the concept of a new learning center. We termed it as Tapas Bold, that's graceful, getting old gracefully. So the concept of new learning is completely based on science. You know, people pursue hobbies as in what they like to do. But when if we encourage them to pursue, take up some new activity or skill to learn, which they've never ever done in their lives, that is what is going to stimulate the brain. Activities that can be done by senior citizens, like learning a new language, learning a new instrument, right from learning bridge or dramatics, theater, dance movement therapy. So we identified 12 different activities which could be conducted at Tapas. So now it is not only for the residents of Tapas, but there are people coming in all over from Pune. They have registered here. Then I appointed a psychologist who could guide them through which activities to take up. So now we have a film club, a library, and a film club is now not only about watching films. There's a film critic coming in once in a while, and we have a full timetable for it. And so they learn how to write about a film.
These are professional people.
The whole process of being sensitive towards the subject of the film, or, you know, watching it and then putting it into your own words. It is all their minds and their brains that are stimulated, and they get working. They hear each other's stories. They learn from each other. So this is a whole ecosystem that is being built, actually.
There is a lot more that Tapas does, and how social responsibility works between the younger generations, older generations. Tell us a bit about, you know, the school children coming or these sort of activities as well.
When I was setting up Tapas, what I realized was there's a huge treasure of knowledge that is just lying dormant after the retired life. So I thought that maybe, you know, they could share it, and as they have a lot of time, they could even learn things. So this intergeneration knowledge sharing program came into place, and I have tie-ups with different types of schools. Like there's a convent school as well, there's a school for the underprivileged, and school for special kids. So we have different kinds of kids coming in to Tapas. They do activities together with the senior citizens residing at Tapas, as well as other senior citizens coming in. So we had this wonderful program where they learned origami together, three generations together, right from my team of doctors and social workers. They all enjoyed learning origami together because they were all doing it for the first time in their lives, no matter the age group. So this was a very, very enlightening program and a memorable evening as well. So this is what we're doing. Even the special kids that come from the school, they have been performing here. The senior citizens enjoyed so much. And so this interaction and spending time together is giving actual light to their lives, actually. It's not only about that evening or only about that activities. As you said, a week before and a week later, they all are so happy and cheerful. For one program, I had arranged a lot of junk food for the children. And I can share one experience where a 92-year-old Azoba, he said, no, I want one first. Then I can share it with the kids. So.
And then I understand that you also have these Ajis and Azobas teaching these children.
There was an auntie who came to stay with us who had her only son residing in US. And she had been teaching German and English for her whole life. So I had given her a room on the ground floor and there was a government school nearby. I went and requested the principal there that she's a very knowledgeable person who's staying here and she has all the time and the inclination to teach children, but if only if you could send them to Tapas. So right from the next day, there were like small children chirping around in Tapas and I could find their footwear in a line. Aligned and they were looking forward for that 1 hour to be spent with Aji. And now the learning started, but along with that there was another Aji grandma who started making laddus for them. Kids brought in so much life and smiles all their faces and of course they learned good English.
I mean, all of these activities and all of this superb care wouldn't have been possible without your staff. And I mean, I read somewhere you've got such high standards. You've got one carer per two patients. I mean, that's amazing. That's a huge amount and number of staff, skilled staff. Tell us a bit about how you recruit the staff. Tell us a bit about your team.
As I've always said, that I've been blessed to have good people around, as I have a good team. They are now trained. They were not as skilled as when they joined. But what I realized was when I started taking care of the staff team, the quality of care for the senior citizens was immense. So their emotional well-being is as important. We have our own fun times. We also are psychiatrists who are on my panel. They help them a lot. They've been taking regular sessions for their emotional training, right from the physiotherapist, taking care of yourself when you're taking care of the patient. So actually, it involves a lot of physical part as well when they have to lift them or change diapers or take them walking. So when they're doing that, they need to take care of their own body also. Most of them are from rural areas. The attendants, who are, they have a certain feeling of they're doing this for their own parents who are staying in the village. So they are staying away from their homes. So Tapas has become like a home for them too. They get super attached to the residents. They get possessive about them. I do prefer to hire them from rural areas. I have a complete team of youngsters, you know, they're in their 20s and 30s who have done their masters in social work. So that gives them an edge and I hire them as freshers because what I saw when they work somewhere else, the unlearning takes a lot of time.
But when I was conversing with you, for example, two things that really struck me about the staff is that I know during the COVID times, the staff said, we will carry on working here. We don't want to go back home in spite of such tough, hard times for them. Yeah. They actually chose to stay with you, which means, and I hate to use the word employer, but as a didi, as a tai or whatever they call you, you really are giving care not just to the ajis and azubas, but to the staff as well. And I know you said something else which really struck me, that you actually wrote back home to each of these staff people's homes saying that, don't worry, I will look after them.
So they all are staying with us. So actually, morally, I feel this, that they are my responsibility, especially the girls. their safety and their well-being. Of course, their progress as well. So we do encourage them to do further courses in psychology, nursing, physiotherapy. When this situation arised, I could see a lot of old age homes or such centers closing down because of the lack of staff. And there was a lot of migration happening where the staff from the hotels or hospitality, they were all going off home. So there was a time when I had to actually ask all of them, what do you want to do? And just take your time and let me know, speak to your family members. And I was amazed that their families supported as well, because their families living in these remote villages could know, you know, in the news or in the newspapers that Pune or Mumbai was the worst affected. It was an overwhelming moment for me. I would never forget that. Then they all told me that we want to stay back. Wow. And they felt safe in the premises of Tapas. Inside the gate, we have our own world. Mm. Where COVID, the word is not even familiar to us. Mm. Of course, I put all the precautions in place. Right away, the family visits were reduced. No outsiders, no visitors. So they knew that they were safe inside. I had made it compulsory for them to talk to their families once a day and tell them that they're okay. So I had to ask them in the evening, sabne baat kiya ki nahi, ghar pe baat hui ki nahi. So
as if there weren't enough accolades is the word, isn't it, to what you do. Another one of the things that you also do is you go and speak about social service as a career.
So I had not realized that I would actually set up an example. Mm-hmm. I just kept doing what felt right. So when I started off, I was very sure that I don't want to register this as an NGO, because then being dependent on donations somehow brings down the quality of work. I wanted to build up a sustainable model, a revenue model where a non-profit organization, of course, but where, you know, as I said, the staff team, the salaries and the quality of even the vendors, everyone needs to be happy. I was approached by these organizations or universities to talk about it. It is very interesting to speak with the younger generation, the students of IIT or other universities. And I do encourage young scientists from like NCL to come and, you know, work here or do their research. What I used to talk with them and which worked was talking about the social entrepreneurship aspect of it. Mm-hmm. So when I went through the dilemma where, you know, I could see some people doing a commercial business out of it, and I needed to find a way to stick to my ethics genuinely, and this is what shaped up. Yeah. Sustainability was the main issue here, or there's so much need of more care homes, then the younger generations needs to be motivated to do it. And generally the scenario on social work is like people who wear khadi and go around asking for donations, and actually that they can sustain taking this up as a career option. Not only with senior citizens, there's a huge scope to do so much more work.
And in the same vein of things, you know, I know you also look after some elderly completely free of charge. And you also work with local organizations. You go and consult. You share your knowledge with such elderly care organizations.
At least few residents who can avail these services who are in need. And then we can actually take care of the whatever expenses are incurred. There are, as I always say, the families who have their parents staying with us are my biggest support. So they have supported in this venture. Mm-hmm. And other organizations, as one of the oldest care homes, old age care homes in Pune, which was actually established during the British era.
Oh, wow.
Niwara. So I go there. So what I felt was, how can I help? Mm-hmm. So unless you train the staff, unless actually you sensitize them with empathy towards care and towards systematic care, only then this can be achieved. And I have help from some wonderful family members. So we have this group. We have formulated certain training programs, and also working on the validation of these care homes. So kind of building a maturity model which new care homes can also follow.
Obviously, with elderly care comes palliative care. Yeah. How do you deal with palliative care? How do you deal with inevitable, passing ons?
It is unsaid somehow that their last breath is going to be at the bus. Mm-hmm. So it goes unsaid most of the time at active aging center. They have expressed this, the people who come to stay at our place, they have asked me, is there at any point you might say that, no, now I can't take care. So that triggered, I can never ever say that. I have to be prepared. So this is called as a transitional aging phase, where now they are like at 70 or 75, they are fit and fine, but with age or with different ailments, of course, it's a practical reality of life that they are going to decline. The physical health is going to decline, and transitional, as in they might have to the wheelchair or a bed or getting bedridden, are inevitable truths of life. So I needed to be prepared for that. I did few courses in palliative care with Karuna Shrine in Bangalore, and I was blessed to have a very renowned palliative care expert on my team also, who guided me through. And his dedication or his empathy was most touching. I had to train staff likewise. So palliative care is more of when the family members are, and the person himself is very clear that they don't want any aggressive medical interventions. So this could be with a terminal illness like cancer or dementia. But also in normal aging, people are taking such practical decisions now. We are not just going to stop any medical treatments, but symptomatic relief and the patient's comfort. So now the quality of life matters, Palliative care starts when you ask a question, do you think this person might live for another 3 days or for 3 months? Of course, the emotional part of it is most important. So at times, senior citizens who have come to stay with us for palliative care especially, they have expressed certain desires, and we have immense pride and satisfaction in actually fulfilling it. It could be a small chocolate or a orange candy of like which we used to get 50 years back in their childhood. So I've been able to procure it from somewhere. And of course, the conversations with the families, making video calls for them, just being with them helps a lot. Each day is different. Each person has been different. So palliative care is something very, very close to my heart. And I would really love to expand that work. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it becomes a very sacred space when a death happens, for the staff to be able to console and counsel you. Yeah. You get them to speak to psychiatrists, and yes. You have a certain routine that you follow. They come and do namaskar, and they say their goodbyes to the person.
Yeah, the caretakers who have been very attached to them, they go through a lot. So this is where the emotional training comes in. Our psychiatrists, of course, help us a lot. We have these weekly meetings as well. So I urge them, I motivate them to express themselves firstly. So they need to express, they need to share their experiences, share their feelings. Once you're taking care and the person is getting better, is in itself a very rewarding part. But here that doesn't exist. And the person himself might not be able to even say thanks or respond. But even then, doing it with the same integrity, the same consistency is what matters, but it takes a lot.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
So we need to take care of these caregivers. So we talk a lot, and we talk about the person, the good things, the good memories, mm-hmm. and we need to bring a good emotional closure to it.
So it's an occasion to celebrate the person's life.
Actually, we've done that, and most of the times, families have done that here at Tapas. They have opted to come and share these moments with us. One family, they lost their father who was at Tapas for a long time. The son called that we have these last rites and we have this asthi. is it okay if he remains at tapas?
Oh,
we want
so
to plant the tree,
remain at
the
tapas.
ashes. Yeah, so they have so they've planted a tree at tapas with his ashes, and which is into a full bloom. So the whole closure and the bonding with these families is,
and that's there. I mean, what more gratitude would one want, right?
So these such moments are so precious to us. What you can say is such precious moments, as you said, funny or surprising or very touching, is almost a routine for us.
Yeah,
it happens almost every day that there's something I take back home, and at the end of the day it touches my heart. Very initially when we started, there was a couple who came to stay with us, and the Aji, the granny, she was ill with a terminal illness, and we took care of her and she passed away. And her husband staying with us, he went through the whole process staying in the same room. So it struck me that I need to take care of him. But he was going through unimaginable pain, seeing her everyday deteriorating. So I had set up a routine for him. So whenever she used to sleep, I used to take him for a walk. So this bonding happened, and when she passed away, he suddenly told the family that I want to stay here. And he's still with us here. He's one of the stars. I always say that we have in-house counselors. So these senior citizens staying with us since a long time, they counsel the staff, they counsel the new people who come to stay with us. They motivate them. So I always say it very proudly that he's our in-house counselor. Also at dementia center, where the families are really anxious. On the day, you know, there are discussions going on. We have certain number of meetings by the time they come to the decision that their parents need to stay here, and it's not manageable at home medically, psychologically. So that's that experience on the day of admission is again very, very emotional. We keep the paperwork as less as possible. So there's a certain amount of official work. But then so many families have shared with me that they actually could imagine their parents leaving them at school when they were small.
Role reversal.
Anxiety that they must have experienced. So they say that it's the same that we are feeling today. And they keep calling, how's she doing? So we say, we have video calls, we show them how they're doing. And then, of course, they come and meet them so many times. And we have days for the family visits, and it's so informal. I hate rules, actually. Whatever the daughters or the sons, when they come, they meet all of them. It's not only their father or mother, they meet all of them.
Because it's a whole big family.
Yeah, we have a lot of activities in the mornings. So there are games going on, somebody's painting or they're playing carom. When the family members have come to meet them, like the grandma or the grandpa, who's, they go and meet their family members, and they've said ki, now you can leave, you know, I need to go get back to my painting, or there's some competition going on and I need to go there now. Your family members don't know how to react, really, because they're happy to see them settled as well. But
but again, similar to what happened when they went to school,
when they were small.
So I would also like to mention something that we still haven't covered, as to, you know, in the Indian sort of cultural context, you do so many things with them. You celebrate every single festival.
Yeah.
Or you have, like, now we have the mango season, and you told me you're going to have like a panna, which is like a mango drink, tomorrow. How you've celebrated monsoons with like pakodas and chai.
Yeah, it's more for our sake also, you know. Towards the end of the month, last week of the month, we have a whole timetable for the next month ready. So whatever festivals are coming in, birthdays, and for the summers again, we have more drinks, raw mango or buttermilk, and so to maintain their sodium levels, actually it is very important,
right?
But we need to make it more interesting. So I need to find out what things were when they were younger, not now, you know, so what they can relate to. The focus is more on making each day happier. So the festivals, like Hardi Kumku, the cultural festivals what we used to celebrate, and Ganesh festival, Diwali is amazing. And a few years back when the Ganesh festival, so what we decided was we're not going to buy things this time. We're going to prepare everything at the bus. So we prepared the Ganesh idol, the diyas and the decoration, all the sweets and the goodies. So this is how we need to make it interesting, and the staff gets involved. Just few days back, they had painted their all the ajis, the grandma's nails with different shades, you know. So many families told us that she must have never had a nail paint in her life. So they have a spa day as well. They have a pedicure and such things also. We cannot have a monotonous routine, you know. There's a cheat day for diabetes as well. So most of them have diabetes. So we have a controlled diet for specifically diabetes. But of course, there's a complete cheat day where we have puran polis or sweets, and they have it to their heart's content. And they do deserve it.
Yeah. Or the other day when you said, oh, we had barfase gore, which is ice lollies, and you made them on the premise, especially in these COVID times, you know, you made sure that you made them in house.
Around those times, 50 years back, or they used to prepare ice cream.
Handmade ice cream.
Very handmade. So we're going to do that.
Okay. So you could do it yourself.
Yeah, so I have that. So of course they can't do much, but then the staff is ever ready and very enthusiastic, because again, for this generation, it's a very new thing. They never knew. They only knew that you go and buy ice cream. They didn't know how to make it. So they all come together and make it. So maybe during these COVID times, with all the limited resources, they had to be inside the premises. Maybe now we have come up with even more innovative ideas.
But it was such a pleasure talking to you, Prajakta. It's really, really enjoyable. And it's incredible to see how you keep going. It's so difficult to keep that motivation going in a field like this. No, thank you. Thank you for coming on Cafe Rainy Days.
And now, let's meet a few residents of Tapas.
So, Devdada, tumhi kiti divas ahat ithe? Kiti varsha zali tumhala?
He jeva suru zala na? Tevha pasun ami ithe, 4 varsha zali.
Oh,
wow. Ami me and Mrs. तिला कॅन्सर झाला होता तर दोघं होतो पण ती राहिली नाही तर त्यानंतर मी राहायला डिसाईड केलं की इथं चांगलं आहे मला इथेच राहिलो इथे एक तर फ्रेंडली अटमॉस्फिअर आहे दुसरं आमच्यासारख्या लोकांना मेडिकल अटेन्शन खूप लवकर एकदम मिळतं इथलं म्हणजे डॉक्टर आठवड्यातून येऊन जातात पण इथे स्टाफला ट्रेन्ड आहेत स्टाफ आणि त्यांच्यापेक्षा बेसिक सगळे इन्स्ट्रुमेंट वगैरे आहेत आणि रोज असतं ब्लड प्रेशर आणि टेम्परेचर आणि ब्लड शुगर वगैरे ते घेतलं जातं रेग्युलरली आणि डॉक्टर मार्गातून येऊन देतात तर ते औषध इथेच मागवतात आणि इथे आम्हाला स्वतःला गोळ्या पण निघाव्या लागतात त्या गोळ्या आम्हाला दररोज अगदी रेग्युलरली देतात लोकेशन चांगलं इथे मी राहतोय चांगलं क्लीन आणि व्हेरी पीसफुल लाईफ आहे आणि लोक सगळे आसपास फ्रेंडली आहेत आणि अगदी घरच्यासारखं वाटत हा
मेन घरच्यासारखं वाटत मग तुम्ही जेव्हा म्हणजे वर्किंग आयुष्यात होतात तेव्हा तुम्ही काय करायचा
मी बेसिकली इंजिनियर आहे म्हणजे प्रोफेशनली मी टाटा स्टील मध्ये होतो तिथे पास झाला मी बिट्स पिलानी होऊन पास झालो आणि टाटा स्टील मध्ये 38 वर्ष राहून म्हणजे रिटायर झालो चीफ इंजिनियर होतो तिथे टाटा जमशेदपूरला इथे नाही आता इथे मी एक तर म्युझिक मला गाणी आवडतात क्लासिकल लाईट म्युझिकल सगळ्या प्रकारची तर सिस्टम माझ्याकडे आहे त्याच्यावरती बसून ऐकू शकतो कधी पण मला पुस्तकं वाचण्याची फार सवय हा आवडतात लायब्ररी पण इथे आणि मला दोन मुली आहेत मला नातींशी बोलायला फार मजा येते
तुमची तपस मधली नातवंड आहेत, त्यांच्याबद्दल काहीतरी सांगा.
लीलाधर म्हणून आहे ज्याने आता फोन धरून ठेवला माझ्या समोर. तो एक्सपोर्ट त्याला काही पण सांगा, तो की कार्पेंटरी, पेंटिंग, प्लम्बिंग, त्याला काही इलेक्ट्रिकल वॉटर ते, आणि माझा मोबाईल काही प्रॉब्लेम असेल तर तो सॉल्व्ह करतो. जॅक ऑफ ऑल ट्रेड म्हणतात तसा आहे. आणि व्हेरी गुड लाईक अ फ्रेंड. रेश्मा इथे बसलेली आहे, ती सुद्धा खूप हेल्पफुल आहे. आणखी आमचं मेडिकल साईड सगळी पाहते, औषधं काही लागली काही लागली तर ती मागवून देते आणि औषध वेळच्या वेळी देतात. आय एम व्हेरी हॅपी हिअर. म्हणजे आता मला माझं लास्ट इथे, आय डोंट वॉन्ट टू गो एनी अदर प्लेस अँड गो अप, दिस इज द लास्ट प्लेस फॉर मी टू एज वेल बिंग अ लाईफ हिअर. मी आता या मे मध्ये 91 पूर्ण करीन.
माय गुडनेस, कुठल्याही अँगलने 91 वाटत नाही.
कृपा म्हणा काळाची, द टाइम इज डिसाइड्स एव्हरीथिंग. आणि याच्यावरती आय हेल्प देम बाय डुईंग सम एक्सरसाइज अँड ट्राइंग टू कीप फिट.
खूप खूपच खूपच मजा आली म्हणजे तुम्हाला भेटून
आणि बोलून. आय मनाचा आशीर्वाद, आय होप दॅट यू विल लिव्ह अ व्हेरी सुखी आणि आनंदित जीवन.
हॅलो,
मग तुमचाच बर्थडे होता काल?
हो माझाच.
अरे वा, हॅपी बर्थडे. कसा केला सेलिब्रेट बर्थडे, काय केलं?
मी जरा थोड्याशा निराळा हटके जरा केलं.
बर,
माझी एक मैत्रीण आहे तिची सून गाणारी आहे, तर तिचं रेकॉर्डेड गाणे व्हिडिओ तिने लिंक करून पाठवला होता. आणि ऍज युजल आमच्या लोकांचे खूप उत्साही आहेत, ते सर्व दृष्टीने आणि इथे सगळे इक्विपमेंट्स आहेत त्याच्यामुळे काय म्हणायचं रे त्यांना,
प्रोजेक्टर.
हा, प्रोजेक्टरवर जो संबंध एक तासाचा जुन्या गाण्यांचा प्रोग्राम दाखवला. आणि त्याच्याबरोबर मी सगळ्यांना भेळ आणि पण अशी मेजवानी दिली, संगीत मेजवानी.
मस्त,
इथं वातावरण खूप चांगलं आहे आणि हे सगळे खूप कोऑपरेटिव्ह आहेत आणि उत्साही आहेत. मुख्य म्हणजे त्यांना एखादी गोष्ट सांगितली की ते आपलीच आहे असं समजून सगळं करतात.
आपुलकी आहे खूप.
आमचं आता घरच झालेलं. मी एक वर्ष झालं मला, मी एकटी होत झाले 3 वर्षापूर्वी माझे मिस्टर केल्यानंतर. हा, तपास मध्ये मी सध्या जरा थोडासा याच्याकडे वळलेलं आहे की पानात टाकू नका आणि पाण्याचा योग्य वापर करा. पाणी जेवढ्याच तेवढंच पाणी वापरायचं आणि अन्न पानात टाकायचं नाही, त्याची जाणीव निर्माण करण्याचा प्रयत्न मी करतो. सध्या मी स्क्रॅबल खेळायला शिकले इथे येऊन.
अच्छा,
अगदी नवीन होत, मला त्याच्यातला हो का ठो माहिती नव्हतं. ते इथल्या मैत्रिणीमुळे मिळालं. इथलं लायब्ररी फार सुंदर आहे त्याच्यामुळे आणि वातावरण चांगलं आहे. ही सगळी इतकी कोऑपरेटिव्ह आणि इतकी काळजी घेणारी मुलं मुली आहेत या, मी म्हणजे मुलं मुलीच म्हणते, खूप सगळ्यांचा गरजा पुरवणं हे त्यांचं मुख्य काम आहे. तुम्ही तोंडातून काही काढा की
झालं. आणि कोविडमध्ये सुद्धा तपसनी तुमची खूप खूप काळजी घेतली आणि तपस हॅज मॅनेज टू कीप ऑल ऑफ यू सेफ.
सगळ्या तऱ्हेने काळजी घेत आहे, सगळ्या तऱ्हेने, सगळ्या बाजूने. नंतर आणि सगळे सण साजरे करतात ना आणि छान तऱ्हेने साजरे करतात. आज माझा वाढदिवस होता ना, त्यांनी मिळून भेळ आणि पण केलं, ही ऍक्टिव्हिटीज झाली की.
हो हो,
आता मे मध्ये आईस्क्रीम बनवणार आहे.
अरे वा.
आणि इथे म्हणजे आम्ही चॉकलेट्स बनवले ना, ते आम्ही हे केल्या, परवा पापड्या टाकल्या आहो.
अरे वा,
साबणाच्या पापड्या सगळ्यांनी छान अरेंज केलं होतं. असे निरनिराळे प्रयोग करत असतात.
खूपच मजा आली, थँक्यू व्हेरी मच आणि हॅपी बर्थडे अगेन.
थँक्यू, धन्यवाद.